I was misdiagnosed back in 2009, been told that it was a stroke in the brain, and stayed 1 month believing that I had a stroke.
The commonest condition that gets misdiagnosed in patients who have multiple sclerosis actually is stroke. Like if you get weak on the right side of the body, that can present as a cerebral stroke.
And after that, I went to the BDF when I got diagnosed over there with Dr. Mohamed Fellah with multiple sclerosis. So we can count it as it was from 2009, but I didn't know about it till mid of, like, after 2 months of the first diagnosis.
In 2012, I have a new experience. I felt I'm not the same as every day. I discovered I cannot feel my fingers. I cannot remember many things. And after a while, I discovered that I have MS. The last stage of the symptoms was I was paralyzed, half the body, the right side. It was the worst period in my life. It was very hard.
طبعا بداية القصة كانت في 2009. كانت مع بداية دخولي للهندسة جامعة البحرين. كنت يمكن أعاني العديد من الضغوطات النفسية غير الضغوطات الدراسية. أول شيء صادني حسيت بانقسام فريلي وبتنميل في يدي. وبعدين طبعا أنا ما اهتمت لهذا الموضوع، يعني ما كنت وايد حاطة ذيك الأهمية، بس بعدين بديت أحس بثقل في مشي، ما كنت أقدر أمشي، ما كنت أقدر أتحرك. فالوالد كان عنده صديق هو دكتور أعصاب، زرته وأجرى العديد من الفحوصات. وبعدين طبعا في 2009 بين شهر مايو ويونيو اكتشفت أن فيني تصلب عصبي.
I had my first attack when I was 11. I felt like I couldn't move. My legs were heavy. I didn't have, like, I don't know the word, but I couldn't do anything. I was disabled in some way. This last year, I had the second attack. I had optic neuritis. I didn't see with my left eye, and I was diagnosed last year when I was 14.
All the multiple sclerosis patients, they go with an MRI for the spine and for the spinal cord and brain. So that would confirm the diagnosis, and that's what happened with me.
The main test that we do for multiple sclerosis, because there are multiple lesions in the central nervous system, including the brain and the spine, is to do the best available MRI scan of the appropriate area. So if there is an involvement of the brain, then we do MRI of the brain. If there's an involvement of the spine, then we do MRI of the cervical spine. In addition, we have to do a special test, and that is to take out the fluid from the back, and that fluid is called as a cerebrospinal fluid. And that fluid has to go in for examinations to understand why this particular patient is getting the symptoms related to the multiple sclerosis disease process itself.
MRI, I was not sure if I can do it or no. I was scared, but after a while I insist on it. My case was very difficult, and I did it, thanks God, and we discovered it is MS. I don't know what is MS, but it's only a name for me, but at least I know what's going on.
طبعا انا خضعت لاشعه رنين المغناطيسي اللي هي الام ار اي اكثر من 3 لـ4 مرات، وفي بعض التمارين العصبيه اللي قام فيها الدكتور باستخدام ادوات تشوف ما مدى تجاوب الاعصاب. وفي افكر ان مع الايام الجايه اخضع لي اكثر من اختبار عشان اشوف ما مدى تجاوب اعصابي. وطبعا خارج البحرين ايضا سووا لي تمارين يمكن شوي حديثه مو موجوده في البحرين، كانت تقيس ما مدى تجاوب الاعصاب بدقه شديده.
In 2010 I had an MRI, but it wasn't clear that I have multiple sclerosis. Last year when I did the MRI, it seemed that I have multiple sclerosis. So MRI.
Actually, there was no reaction because I didn't know what the sickness was. But the doctor gave me like a piece of paper and he told me, if you'd love to read, go and explore and see what the sickness is. Plus, he said you have the first stage. So when you're going to go with that, read about relapse remitting. And that's the first stage of multiple sclerosis.
Multiple sclerosis, by definition, are problems related to the brain and the nerves, which come and go. Come and go in the sense that there is a particular paralysis which can come suddenly, but as time goes by, that particular deficit or paralysis becomes better day by day with medicines or by nature. And the patient actually becomes normal and carries on their normal activities and even forgets about the fact that he or she had some problem maybe years back. And then this problem comes back again. And it's very unpredictable on which day, at what time it will come. So that is the meaning of relapsing and remitting. Relapsing means that the paralysis comes and gets relapsed again. And remitting is the reverse process of getting better on its own or with medications.
I didn't feel bad at the start. I was a little bit active on the health social part. So didn't scare me at the start.
I was shocked. I felt that all my dreams were shattered. I was prepared myself to do many things, and suddenly I have to stop and think about it again and again.
As soon as they get this news that they are part of the multiple sclerosis disease process, they actually become very, very anxious. Some of them start crying right at the beginning that they are suffering from an incurable disease, and many of them get depressed over a period of time. And matters are made worse by relatives who have half knowledge and do not understand the basic process of the disease process. Now, that it is an incurable disease is in a way not true, because more and more medications and newer medications related to the research process of the disease process have come out, and people have become better. And there are many patients over a period of 8 to 10 years, they're leading normal life. They get, females get pregnant, they have children, and they are absolutely normal in all respects. And the other side of the spectrum is also true, that there are patients who land up in the wheelchairs and they are incapacitated, and they have to be supported by the family, and they feel that there is going to be a burden on the families. So both aspects of this disease process is true, but I think with more and more research, more and more people are getting better over the years than what we used to see and do about 10-15 years back.
انا اول ما سمعت ان فيني تصلب عصبي صراحه ضحكت. يمكن شعور غريب بالنسبه لشخص يبلغون انه هو مريض, بس يمكن لان انا كنت قارئ عن ذي المرض قبل شهور قليله من انه هو يصيبني. كنت قارئ عنه بحيث ان انا كنت مطلع, مجرد ان انا كنت اعمل كصحفي وككاتب فكنت اطلع على هالنوعيه من الامراض, فكنت قارئ عن المرض قبل لا يصيبني. فاول ما صادني صراحه ضحكت, وما كان عندي شعور ان انا مريض او ان يعني كنت مبالي وايد ان انا مريض, لا بالعكس كان شعور جدا مريح. لكن يمكن الشعور السيء صاد اسرتي, يعني اسرتي كانوا وايد متاثرين ان انا مرضت بهاي المرض, وكان بالنسبه لهم شيء غريب, وكان بالنسبه لهم شيء يمكن مخيف, خاصه انه هو في الاعصاب او في المخ. فبالنسبه لهم شيء ان يعني بما اني انا الابن الاصغر فكان الخوف وايد علي, وكان يعني شيء ما اقدر اوصفه شعور اهلي في ذيك الفتره.
I was scared. First of all, I was shocked. I didn't know that there is something called multiple sclerosis. And someone told me that I have multiple sclerosis. If I don't do that, I'll get that, or that's what happened. I was shocked and scared.
I was half paralyzed the first time, and it didn't come back again until I got optic neuritis the second time.
It means that the optic nerve gets degenerated, and because optic nerve is related to seeing things, the person is not able to see things suddenly, and he sees darkness in front of the eyes, and sometimes he may see double vision.
I started to see a little bit, but blurry vision. And till I lost vision of the left eye, started to be pitch black. So that was the second time I got an attack.
40% of the patients, they experience usually symptoms in the eye for the first time. So in that strict sense, about more than one third of the patients will definitely have some symptom related to diminishing in the vision or drop in the vision or fog in front of the eyes or blackness in front of the eyes, and they'll not be able to see with either one eye or sometimes even both the eyes. This is the most common symptom. The next common symptom is related to the urinary bladder. That means suddenly a person will not be able to void the urine and he will not be able to urinate properly. This is also a very common symptom for multiple sclerosis. Third common symptom is sudden paralysis of either one side of the body or sometimes even both the legs or sometimes both the hands, depending upon where the multiple sclerosis problem occurs in the nervous system.
First of all, I felt numbness, weakness, and then I lost some feelings. I lost some memory.
Memory loss now has been established as affecting the patients of multiple sclerosis even before the whole process of multiple sclerosis has started. These are recent studies which tell us that memory loss is now becoming a very, very important part of the disease process. And at a later stage, it is very, very evident and very prominent, and patients do realize that their memory is also failing, apart from the fact that they are having multiple episodes of the disease process itself.
And finally, after a few days, I was paralyzed. It was the very worst one for me. I didn't expect that it will happen quickly as this.
The first few episodes of the disease are very, very sudden and very severe. So suddenly, one fine day, a person is normal and gets up normal, and another maybe 1 hour or so, he gets totally paralyzed. And that's a very, very traumatic process. It looks and behaves like a paralytic stroke, and it is also misdiagnosed as a paralytic stroke by many of the doctors who are not aware of the disease process as neurologists are. So in that way, it is very, very disabling. It becomes very traumatic. And it becomes more traumatic because since the disease process is more found in young population to get paralyzed is very, very traumatic to the family.
طبعا الاعراض تختلف من مريض لمريض. انا بالنسبه لي الاعراض اللي صادتني كانت عباره عن تنميل في اليد وانقسام في القدمين وتصلب ويمكن ثقل احيانا في المشي وعدم توازن وعدم تركيز. صرت ما أقدر أركز لأكثر من يمكن 20-30 دقيقة. وأعراض ثانية طبعا يعني في بعضها أتذكرها وبعضها لا، لكن تختلف الأعراض يعني بين فترة لفترة. أيضا الأعراض تعتمد على الطقس، يعني أحيانا في البرد تكون الأعراض مختلفة عن الصيف، عن فصل الربيع. بعد في يعني فرق في الأعراض بالنسبة لي أنا، لكن في وايد بعد مرضى نفس حالتي.
I have experienced numbness, stabbing, everything I guess, even depression.
Any patient who has a chronic disease process, whether it is multiple sclerosis or even diabetes, they do get depressed in the long term from the fact that the disease process is going to last with them forever or for a long period of time. And depression is part and parcel of multiple sclerosis, just like memory loss or memory impairment is now a part and parcel of the multiple sclerosis.
So actually there are two types of medications that you get to avoid the attacks. You start using vitamins that I've been using, like B1, B12, B6, omega-3, D3.
Vitamin D in particular has been known to help the disease process, and many of the doctors add vitamin D supplement to the whole treatment.
Plus, during the attack, you start to use the cortisone, as everyone knows. vein called solomedrol. I use that like 3 times when you have the attack, like three consecutive days. And then we start to get the nerve back again to start living our normal life.
Cortisone does help in the severity of the disease process in the initial 3 to 5 days, and that is very important because cortisone has to be used in most of the patients. This reverses the activity of the multiple sclerosis process, and the patient does become better faster. Now, regarding the side effects of the cortisone, since we are going to use it for a very short period of time, maybe 3 days or 5 days maximum, I don't think that is related to much side effects. In the long run, it may have some side effects if we keep on using it again and again.
My doctor was very careful with me. He started to give me vitamins, multivitamins, and plus my vitamin B, cod oil, and he started to solve the problem with the paralyzation by giving me steroids injections.
Steroid injections are always used in patients who have multiple sclerosis in the sudden acute condition, and it is used for a period of 3 or 5 days, and it is known as pulse therapy of multiple sclerosis treatment.
I was recovered very well. It was fine for me. And after a while, I discovered that because of my lifestyle, it helped me a lot. I was long time ago very careful with my diet, with my weight, with my health. No canned food, no fast food, no tea or coffee. No smoking, of course. Plus, I was enjoying my life in a good way, separating my personal life, and there is a barrier between personal life or practical life and family life. So this has helped me a lot. I think this is like a result for cumulative steps I did long time ago.
طبعا على مدى سنتين ما اخذت اي علاج. لما صادني المرض نفس ما قلت في البداية ان انا كنت غير مبالي فما استخدمت اي علاج على مدى سنتين غير طبعا ابر الكورتيزون اللي كانت تحميني من الانتكاسات اللي تصيبني من فترة لفترة. استخدمت ايضا حبوب كورتيزون. طبعا الحبوب شوي متنتني وسببت لي نوع مثلا يعني شو لوعه او كان اثرها يعني قوي جدا علي لاني اول مره اخذ هذه الحبوب والابر ايضا فيمكن بعدين تمت سنتين ما استخدم اي علاج. بعد سنتين سافرت المانيا وكان طبعا الكلام مرعب من قبل الدكاتره لاسرتي ان المرض جالس يتمادى او قاعد يزيد نشاطه في المخ. فبعد ذلك يعني بديت أنا أفكر بشكل جدي، حسيت إنه في أعراض ضعف ذاكرة، وأنا كتخصص هندسة هذا الشيء أثر على مستواي، أثر على مجموعي، فكان لازم إن أنا أتخذ قرار وأبتدي أستخدم العلاجات الموجودة. بديت بالبيتافيرون وما زلت مستمر عليه. أيضا جالس طبعا أكل العديد من الفيتامينات مثل أوميغا 3 مثل فيتامين دي اللي تساعدني على تخطي هذه المرض، وما زلت مستمر على الإبر.
I took Zoloft, Vitasprone, and I work out because if I work out, I'll let the pain go away by letting sweat just unleash anything. If I have energy, I just unleash it so I won't feel like I'm dying or anything.
Working out and remaining active and being positive and having an optimistic view to the whole process is a nice way to combat the disease, especially since the disease has its own relapsing and remitting attitude.
Actually, I have my own personal way of dealing with the disease itself. It's like I've been told by the members of the society, the doctors themselves, other patients outside environment of work or the society to start taking the medications that are being called beta interferon. But I have my own philosophy against that. I'm against using these drugs. and going with the normal treatment, stress-free, organic food, anything else that will make me avoid the chemicals that they've been using. As I've seen that few of these medications made our friends suffer more than gain more health.
Most of the medicines which are used in multiple sclerosis are related to modulating the immune system of the patient. And we do know that when we try to do the same, sometimes things can go wrong. So some patients do develop severe side effects from the medications, and these side effects are so severe that you actually have to withdraw the medication. In a way, those patients are going to be harmed more by the medications than the good that the medications are going to provide.
So that's my own philosophy. I'm being backed up with my doctor. So he's following up my condition regarding my own philosophy. So far, I'm doing so good.
Actually, I never lose in my life. I was sure that happiness is there, but we have to search for it, or we have to turn right and left to find it. That's all. So this helped me a lot. I have to be very optimistic, and everything will finish quickly.
أنا طبعاً جدا أحب الأشياء النادرة. فيمكن إصابتي بالمرض دي كان بالنسبة لي التصلب العصبي شيء نادر جدا. وحبيت يعني أتأقلم مع المرض كشيء نادر. لما كانوا يسألوني ما كنت أخجل إن أقول لهم إن أنا مريض تصلب عصبي. معنا في وايد ناس تخجل إن تقول أنا مثلا مريضة بهالمرض أو فيني هذه العاهة. بالعكس أنا كنت أشوفها شيء جدا نادر. وشيء يمكن يميزني عن غيري. فهذه كانت استراتيجيتي اللي أنا كنت أتبعها. أيضاً إضافة إلى ذلك كانت فترة يعني بداية دخول المرض علي أنشط فترة بالنسبة لي. كنت نشيط جداً يعني سواء في عملي في الصحافة أو في الكتابة أو حتى في أنشطتي المتنوعة. يعني كنت طاقة يعني جداً. كنت أنتج وأنتج 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 بس عساس أني أنا أوصل فكرة بسيطة للمجتمع أن الإنسان ممكن ينتج ممكن يعمل وممكن يحقق كل اللي يبي حتى لو كان مريض. وإذا كان هو تصلب عصبي لازم إحنا نكسر هذه التصلب ونكون مليئين بالحركة. وأعتقد أن هذه أعظم استراتيجية ممكن يتبعها أي مريض تصلب عصبي، يثبت نفسه ويثبت لغيره أنه ما يحتاج لشفقات الناس.
My philosophy is, after everything bad happens, there's always something good is going to happen.
My personal philosophy as a doctor is that every disease which is chronic is getting researched at very high levels at various institutions. And finally, man is going to be able to conquer most of the disease processes, including cancer. So there is no need to lose hope, and there is no need to feel that one is not going to improve. There is a cure for everything. It's a matter of time, and it's a matter of will of the patient and the optimism that the patient has. So we don't know that even if you have cancer, you still live a good normal life. And this is particularly true in many of the cancers that we know. So relatively, we know that multiple sclerosis is not a cancer. And in a way, you can lead a normal life, even 10 to 12 to 15 years, and absolutely be normal in all respects.
It actually affects the daily activity once you have, like, when you're being stressed. It's like you start feeling the pain in your legs and your arms, you start feeling the fatigue. You can't cope with your co-workers, with the family members. The worst thing about the MS is that it doesn't show, so people can't see it. You're the only one who can feel it. So when you're going to walk with a stick or come with a wheelchair or even say that you are in pain, no one can see the pain except you. So that's the worst part, for people to believe that you actually have the pain.
Because of the variability of the disease process, there are many patients who have got multiple problems when we do the investigations, but from outside they look absolutely normal. So they are able to do their normal activities, and nobody can make out even the doctors are not able to make out that they have multiple sclerosis going on in their body. In a way, yes, nobody will be able to make out unless we do investigations. This disease can cause a lot of disability. Since it affects the eyes, you can become blind. Since it affects the limbs, you can be paralyzed, you can be in a wheelchair, you can be in the bed for a long period of time. And because of this longevity of the disease, you can be depressed, your memory can fail. So yes, it can make a person totally like in a vegetable state and people stop to live altogether. It is very disabling in most of the times, and it is very, very normal most of the time. So one cannot really predict.
The worst thing in my life when I have this MS, it was losing a part of my memory, and I didn't get it at all. It was shocking for me because I cannot remember a lot of things, and I cannot continue because I have a gap in my memory. But I try to recover this step by thinking of a future better than crying about the past.
طبعاً أسوأ شيء ممكن يصيدني في حياتي اليومية أو يعني في أوقات معينة هو فقدان الذاكرة. يعني فقدان الذاكرة شيء جدا أثر علي من مرض التصلب العصبي. بديت أنسى وايد ساعات أحيانا يعني أوقات حتى أقول يعني بين لحظة وثانية, يعني بين 5 دقائق مثلا أنا أكون حاط في مخي إني بسوي شيء وأنسى. فالنسيان زاد عندي جدا, وايضا جت صدني اعراض نفس ما قلت في البدايه, فقدان ذاكره. غير هالشيء يمكن مو يعني اعراض فيني بل اعراض في الناس, عدم فهم الناس, عدم استيعاب الناس لهذه الحاله, ما اقول شفقه لكن عدم فهمهم للحاله المرضيه. دائما الناس تنظر لنا ان احنا ما فينا شيء, ان احنا مجرد يعني شيء هراء اللي احنا قاعدين نقوله, لان يشوفون حالتنا الصحيه احسن ما يكون. بس طبعا هذه بسبب تفاؤلنا او بسبب انه يعني كان قدامي خيارين, اما ان انا اقعد في البيت وانتظر شفقة الناس, واما اني انا اطلع واشتغل ويكون فيني المرض. لكن انا اتخذت الخيار الثاني بالتأكيد, وفي النهاية طبعا يمكن فهم الناس شيء جدا مهم عشان نقدر نوصل حياتنا, لان احنا اصلا عايشين معاهم.
The worst part of this disease called multiple sclerosis is unpredictability. You never know when you are normal at one time and when you are not normal and paralyzed at the next moment. And this is a very bad situation in which patients get very, very anxious. They actually freak out and they even get paranoid. And they are all the time afraid of when the next sword is going to fall on their head. It may not happen for 10 years and may not happen for 12 years, and it can happen tomorrow morning, and that is the worst part of the disease.
The worst thing is not knowing what's going to happen. This is the worst thing. I get over it with a smile.
I have a daughter, she's 1 year old, and just to release all the stress and pain, I just hold her up. The smile can take it all away.
Actually, I follow a very strange method. I was looking at in the mirror, looking to myself, and thinking I have to believe what I see, not what I feel. This is, it was a good idea to understand that I'm fine and I have to continue my life.
Any disease process, which is a chronic disease process, and where the suffering is for a long period of time, whether it is multiple sclerosis or cancer or rheumatoid arthritis, patients do get depressed over the chronicity or longevity of the disease process. And we all do know that there are optimistic patients and there are pessimistic patients. And we also know that happiness in general increases your immunological activity in the body. And indirectly, since multiple sclerosis is an immunological disease, patients who are happier and who are optimistic, they have a better way of combating the disease process.
اللي ساعدني على اجتياز اليوم السيء أعتقد هو عملي، عملي بشكل عام، سواء عملي في الأنشطة، عملي في دراستي، أو عملي في مختلف مجالات حياتي. أعتقد أن العمل يشغلك عن وايد أشياء، يخليك تنسى وايد أشياء. فأعتقد أنه لما توصل لمرحلة أنك أنت مشغول، أحياناً يتعكر مزاجك وكل شيء، بس في النهاية بتنسى أنه أنت مريض MS، أو بتنسى أنه في أعراض MS أصلاً، بتحس نفسك إنسان طبيعي، إنسان يعني مثلك مثل أي إنسان ثاني. أيضاً إضافة إلى ذلك، أصدقائي، مو كلهم، بعضهم، بعض الأصدقاء يساهمون في يعني يخلوني أعيش يوم جداً جميل، يخلوني أعيش يوم طول اليوم من كثرة الفرح أحياناً ما أقدر أنام. يعني الأصدقاء دورهم وايد عود في حياتي. في يعني في الجانب الآخر في أصدقاء طبعاً ما كانوا يساعدوني بتاتاً، لكن في أصدقاء يصنعون يومي.
The thing that helps me most is just praying. I know that God will hear me, so it's the perfect way to get out of a bad day.
Every day is a good day for me, at least. And once it starts with a headache or fatigue, that's when it becomes worse. When it's going to come, it's actually made my daily activity will be harder. How to get it back to normal would be depends on the atmosphere that would surround you at the same time. So if it was family or it was coworkers, people around you should understand what MS is so they can help you to have a better day once you started a bad one.
In general, my life has lots of good days. With MS, I have sometimes bad days, but I have to cancel this idea and keep it good day. You have to switch to good day. The most difficult thing or the secret behind good day or bad day that you have a good night sleep. Otherwise, you will be disturbed for the whole day. So this is the worst thing. You have to enjoy sleeping. So you have to guarantee a good day the second day.
A good 8 hours sleep is going to relax the patient and it's going to lessen the anxiety of the patient. And next day morning is always fresh and you are in a better mood. So in that strict sense of the word, it does relax you and puts you into a better perspective related to the chronicity of the disease.
اليوم السيء بالنسبة لي لما طبعا احنا الأدوية في أبحاث تقول الأدوية اللي احنا ناخذها تسبب اكتئاب، فيمكن ان انت شلون تقدر بإيجابيتك تتغلب على هالاكتئاب. هذه أصعب شيء صد شيء وايد صعب. فأعتقد يكون يوم سيء بالنسبة لي وأكون حزين جدا، وأحيانا أتصرف تصرفات غير عقلانية، وحتى اللي عايشين معاي يقولوا لي انت أمس كنت كذي واليوم تضحك، يعني مستغربين شلون انا تصرفت هاي التصرف بالامس. فالادويه احيانا تجبرنا ان احنا نكون مكتئبين، واصعب شيء ان نتغلب على هذا الاكتئاب. اما بالنسبه حق اليوم الجيد بالنسبه لي، اليوم الجيد اللي اكون فيه يعني نايم من وقت، لان ايضا انا اعتقد ان الادويه تسبب ارق، انا نادرا ما انام من وقت. فاليوم الجيد بالنسبه لي هو اللي انام فيه من وقت، هو اللي كل الظروف تساعدني انه يكون يوم جيد. غالبا ما يكون يعني نص اليوم جيد ونصه سيء، يعني أستانس وأفرح جدا يعني لما أكون نايم من وقت وماخذ أدويتي وكل شيء، لكن نص اليوم الثاني قلب شيء يعني مرعب، أحد يزعلني، ربعي، أهلي، يعني أي أحد. فهذه هو بالنسبة لليوم السيء.
A good day for me is when I don't let MS come to me. When I have numbness, I just get over it and I just say like, no, you're not having that, and everything will go perfect. A bad day when I let MS get to me. Like some days I just think that I have multiple sclerosis, no one is going to love me, I'm just bad, I'm always going to be bad. And when I don't let MS comes to me, it's a perfect day.
We just hope that people can understand what MS is and how to treat people actually who has MS. It's just to see the community understands the needs and how to treat people, that would be the best thing to get right now. So spreading awareness and spreading the culture, how to deal with these people would help us a lot.
I think I'm lucky to have MS because I discovered a lot of things. It wasn't clear for me. Plus, I have to enjoy my dreams now instead of keeping it for the future. I don't know what will happen in the future, so I have to enjoy it now. And I'm doing this now. It is the best conclusion for me.
طبعا نصيحتي لكل يعني لكل مريض تصلب عصبي ان مرض التصلب العصبي لازم ما يوقف في وجهك, لازم ما يخليك تتخاذل, لازم ما يشل نشاطك. يعني مرض التصلب العصبي بيحاول يحاربك, بس انت تكون قد هذه المعركة وانتصر عليه. طبعا هو ما له علاج بالتأكيد, لكن في النهاية لازم تتأقلم معه, لازم تعيش معه, لازم تتأقلم معه مثل ما تأقلمت مع وايد أشياء كانت في حياتك وتأقلمت معها. يعني أنا بالنسبة لي حققت وايد أشياء, حققت وايد إنجازات, وكان الكل كنت وايد أستانس لأن أسمع مثلا لما حقق شيء وايد عود كانوا يقولون فعلا علي تلفات مريض تصلب عصبي, كانوا يستغربون. هاي العبارة كانت وايد تسعدني وايد مو بشوي. فهاي شيء جدا رائع لكل مريض تصلب عصبي. إضافة إلى ذلك, لا تخلي المرض مثلا شيء تبتعد عنه أو تهرب منه, لا, دائما كن معاه. يعني إحنا الآن بعد ما يعني تم تأسيس جمعية مرض التصلب العصبي, أنا ما هربت من الجمعية وقلت مثلا أنا ما بشترك أو أنا ببتعد عن هاي المرض, لا, ساهمت في الجمعية والحمد لله اليوم نائب رئيس جمعية مرض التصلب العصبي وقاعد نعطي قد ما نقدر في هذه الجمعية. فما هربت من المرض, وفي النهاية بعد ما خليته يغلبني, بل بالعكس زرعت هاي الشعور الجيد في كل يمكن أغلب مرضى التصلب العصبي. أيضا سويت مقابلات مع العديد من المرضى وشفت مختلف الحالات وحاولت أحثهم أنهم يكونون نشيطين في حياتهم. هاي نصيحتي لمرضى التصلب العصبي. أما نصيحتي للمجتمع أنه يبحث ويقرأ ويقدر ما هو التصلب العصبي. التصلب العصبي مرض جدا خطير, يعني في ناس وايد تستسهله أو تعتقد أنه هو جدا شيء يعني عادي, لا, هو مرض خطير. لكن كون أن احنا نضحك, كون أن احنا نعيش حياتنا, هذا الشيء ما ينفي أنه هو يكون أقل أهمية من الأمراض الثانية. فأتمنى أن المجتمع يستوعب ما هو التصلب العصبي, يستوعب يعني شنو خطورته على البني آدم, ويقدر هاي الحالات, مو يشفق عليها بل يقدرها.
The way you choose to be is the way you're going to be, so choose it well.
My whole concept of this particular disease process is that we are all human beings. As normal human beings, we are fighting life on a day-to-day basis at all levels. So multiple sclerosis patients are no different. They are normal patients and they have to keep on fighting the disease process. Cure is there. Cure is possible, and some people are going to live a normal daily activity, and getting anxious and depressed about the whole disease process is not going to help. If at all, it is going to only make them worse. There's a very good particular line that I like myself, and that is, keep walking, don't give up.